the button, pull the chain. Here comes the chocolate choo-choo train. Thomas is a tankinion who lives at the big station on the island of Soder. He's a cheeky little Indian with six small wheels, a short stumpy funnel, a short stumpy boiler, and a short stumpy dumb. He's a fussy little Indian too, always pulling coaches about, ready for the big Indians to take on long journeys. And when trains come in, he pulls the empty coaches away so that the big Indians can go and rest. Thomas thinks no Indian works as hard as he does. He loves playing trick on them, including Gordon, the biggest and proudest Indian of all. Thomas likes whistling rudely at him. Wake up, lazy bones. Why don't you work hard like me? One day, after pulling the big express, Gordon had arrived back at the settings very tired. He was just going to sleep when Thomas came up in his cheeky way. Wake up, lazy bones. Do some hard work for a change. You can catch me. And off he ran laughing. Instead of going to sleep again, Gordon thought how he could get back at Thomas. One morning, Thomas wouldn't wake up. His driver and fireman couldn't make him start. His fire went out and there was not enough steam. It was nearly time for the express. People were waiting, but the coaches weren't ready. At last, Thomas started. Oh, dear. Oh, dear, he yawned. He fussed into the station where Gordon was waiting. Hurry up, you, said Gordon. Hurry yourself, replied Thomas. Gordon began making his plan. Yes, said Gordon. I will. And almost before the coaches had stopped moving, Gordon reversed quickly and was coupled to the train. Get in quickly, please, he whistled. Thomas usually pushed behind the big trains to help them start, but he was always uncoupled first. This time, Gordon started so quickly, they forgot to uncouple Thomas. Gordon's chance had come. Come on, puffed Gordon to the coaches. The train went faster and faster, too fast for Thomas. He wanted to stop, but he couldn't. Peep-peep. Stop, stop. Hurry, 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 laughed Gordon. You can't get away, you can't get away, laughed the coaches. Poor Thomas was going faster than he had ever gone before. He was out of breath and his wheels hurt him, but he had to go on. I shall never be the same again, he thought sadly. My wheels will be quite worn out. At last, they stopped at a station. Thomas was uncoupled, and he felt very silly and exhausted. Next, he went on to a turntable, thinking of everyone laughing at him. And then he ran onto a siding out of the way. Well, little Thomas, chuckled Gordon, now you know what hard work means, don't you? Poor Thomas couldn't answer, he had no breath. He just puffed slowly away to rest and had a long, long drink. He went home very slowly, and was careful afterwards never to be cheeky to Gordon again.